course, I have other collectors and maybe, you know, make a decision to buy a piece or not, but that is in the future.
You know what I'm saying?
Before I do a little bit of a, you know.
Now what you've done is beautiful.
Representa una población que existió, pero que dejó unos vestigios muy importantes para la humanidad, como por ejemplo el uso de todos los recursos naturales, el respeto a la mujer, el respeto a la familia. Son valores que se mantienen a través de los siglos, a pesar de que ya no están en la tierra, y creo que podemos recuperar esos valores o tenerlos en cuenta.
At the museum, Elisa was one of the first visitors. And then I began looking at her art as well. And then when we were putting together this particular exhibition called Between I and Thou, this exhibition that talks about the unity of all humanity and of the earth, she started speaking to me about this project that she's been working on for 10 years since she became aware of the tribe of the Selknam in Tierra del Fuego. When she spoke about it, it was with such passion. And then I started to look more at Elisa's work and the way she was drawing on the patterns of the Selknam tribe. And as I say, the passion with which she approached their history and the beauty of what she was composing, just with using natural materials and just dotting it and imprinting it, really with the memory of a past civilization that no longer exists. I was totally captured by it. It's spectacular, and her passion and the beauty of what she created obviously carried over to other people. I wasn't alone.
When I arrived in Tierra del Fuego in 1964, I was 42 years old, and Lola was almost 90. She was the oldest surviving Selknam Indian.
So the performance that we had today involved a musician, a dancer, a narrator, people who were all taken by this story that Elisa is such a wonderful proponent of.